two households, both alike in dignity, in fair Verona, where we lay our scene, from ancient grudge break to new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a pair of star-crossed lovers take their life, whose misadventured piteous overthrows doth with their death bury their parents' strife. The fearful passage of their death-marked love, and the continuance of their parents' rage, which, but their children's end, not could remove, is now the 2 hours' traffic of our stage, the which if you with patient ears attend, what here shall miss, our toil shall strive to mend.
Will not carry coals.
No, but then we should be Colias.
I mean, and we be collar. We'll draw.
Aye, while you live, will you draw your neck out of the collar?
I strike quickly, being moved.
But thou art not quickly moved to strike.
A dog of the house of Montague shall move me.
To move is to stir, to be valiant is to stand. Therefore, if thou art moved, thou runnest away.
A dog of that house shall move me to stand. Therefore, I shall take the wall of any man or maid of Montague.
A weak slave, for the weakest go to the wall.
'Tis true. Therefore, women, being the weaker vessels, are ever thrust at the wall. Therefore, I shall drive these men from the wall and thrust his maids to the wall.
The quarrel is between our masters and us, their men.
'Tis all one. I will show myself a tyrant. When I have fought with the men, I will be cruel with the maids.
Draw thy tool. Here comes two of the house of the Montague.
My naked weapon is out.
Quarrel.
I'll back.
How? Turn thy back and run?
Nay, fear me not.
No, Mary, I fear thee.
Let us take the law of our side. Let them begin.
I will frown as they pass, and let them take it as they list.
Nay, as they dare, I will bite my thumb at them, which is a disgrace to them, if they bear it.
Do you bite your thumb at us, sir?
I do bite my thumb, sir.
Do you bite your thumb at us?
Is the law of our side if I say I?
No.
No, sir. I do not bite my thumb at you, sir. But I bite my thumb, sir.
Do you quarrel, sir?
Quarrel, sir? No, sir.
But if you do, sir, I am for you. I serve a good a man as you.
No better.
Well?
Say better. Here comes one of my master's kinsmen now.
Yes, better, sir.
Lie.
Draw, beauty men. Gregory, remember thy swashing blow?
Die, Montague!
Oh. Put down thy weapons, you know not what you do.
What? Art thou drawn among these heartless hinds? Turn thee, Benvolio, look upon thy death.
I do but keep the peace. Put up thy sword and manage it to part these men with me.
What? Drawn and talk of peace? I hate the word, as I hate hell and all Montagues in the world. Have at thee, coward!
Flourishes his blade in spite of me. My sword, I say!
Thou villain, Capulet!
purple fountains issuing from your veins. Throw your mistempered weapons to the ground and hear the sentence of the ruined prince. Three silver balls, but of an arid word, by the old Capulet and Montague, have thrice disturbed the quiet of our streets and made Verona's ancient citizens cast by their grave these seeming ornaments. Two wheeled old partisans, as hands as old, cankered with peace, you pot your cankered hate. If ever you disturb our streets again, your lives shall pay the forfeit of the peace. For this time, all the rest depart away. You, Capulet, shall belong with me. Montague, come you this afternoon. To not for the pleasure in this case. To old Freetown, our common judgment place. Once more, in pain of death, all men depart!
Who set this ancient quarrel new approach? Speak, nephew, were you by when it began?
Here were the servants of your adversary, and yours close fighting your added approach. I do depart them. But in the instant came the fiery Tybalt with the sword prepared, which, as he breathed defiance to my ears, swung about his head and cut the winds. Who nothing hurt with all hissed him in scorn. While we were interchanging thrusts and blows, came more and more, and fought on part and part. Until the prince came, who parted to be the part.
Oh, where is Romeo? Saw you him today? Right, glad I am he was not at this fright.
So early waking did I see your son. I towards him I made, but he was ware of me, and stole into the coverts of the wood. I, measuring his affections by my own, the most are busied when they're most alone, being one too many by my weary self, pursued my humor, not pursuing his. And gladly shunned, who gladly fled from me.
Many a morning hath he there been seen. And tears hog many the fresh mornings too. Adding to clouds more clouds with his deep sighs. But also soon as the all-cheering sun should in the furthest east begin to draw the shady curtains from Aurora's bed. Away from light steals home my heavy son. And private in his chamber pens himself. Shuts up his windows. Locks fair daylight out. Makes himself an artificial knight. How black and portentous must his humor prove, unless good counsel may the cause remove.
Well, my noble uncle, do you know the cause?
I neither know it, nor can learn it of him.
Have you importuned him by any means?
Both by myself and many other friends. But he, his own affection, his counselor, is to himself. I will not say how true, but to himself, so secret and so close. Could we but learn from whence his sorrows grow, we would have willingly give cure as known.
See where he comes. So please you step aside. I'll know his grievance, else be much denied.
I would thou wert so happy by thy stay to hear true shrift. Come, madame, let's away.
Good morrow, cousin.
Is the day so young?
But new struck nine.
Ay me. Sad hours seem long. Was that my father that went hence so fast?
It was. What sadness lengthens Romeo's hours?
Not having that which having makes them short.
In love.
Out.
Of love.
Out of her favor, rhyme and love.
Alas, that love. So gentle in his view should be so tyrannous and rough and cruel.
Alas, that love whose view is muffled still should without eyes see pathways through his will. Where shall we dine? Oh, me, what fray was here? Yet, tell me not, for I have heard it all. He has much to do with hate. But more with love. Why then, oh, brawling love, or loving hate, or anything of nothing first created? Heavy lifeless, serious vanity, misshapen chaos of well-seeming forms. Feather of lead, bright smoke, cold fire, sick health, still waking sleep. That is not what it is. This love feel I. Feel no love in this. Dost thou not laugh?
No, cuz. I rather...
Good heart, it's what?
At thy my good heart's oppression.
Greece, mine own lie heavy in my breast, which thou wilt propagate to have oppressed with more of thine. This love that thou hast shown doth add more grief to too much of mine own. But what is it else? A madness most discreet, a choking gall, and a preserving sweet? Farewell, my cousin.
Soft, I'll go along. If you leave me so, you do me wrong.
Touch, I have lost myself, I am not here. This is not Romeo, he's some other where.
Tell me in sadness, who is it that you love?
What? Shall I groan and tell thee?
Groan? Why no?
But sadly, tell me who? Bid a sick man in sadness make a will. A word iller is to one that is so ill. Oh, in sadness, cousin, I do love a woman.
I am so close when I suppose to love.
Well, in that right fair mark, she's fair I love.
A right fair mark as soon as him.
Oh, well, in that you miss. She will not be hit with Cupid's arrow. She hath Diane's wit. And, in strong proof of chastity well armed, from love's weak childish bow, she lives unharmed. She will not stay the siege of loving terms, nor bide the encounter of assailing eyes, nor open at the saint's seducing gold. Oh, she is rich in beauty, only poor that when she dies, doth beauty die her stole.
Well, then she hath sworn to live chaste.
She hath. And in that sparing makes huge waste. For beauty starved with her severity cuts beauty off from all posterity. She's too fair, too wise, wisely too fair to merit bliss by making me despair. She hath forsworn to love, and in that vow do I live dead that live to tell it now.
Be ruled by me. Forget to think of her.
Oh, teach me how I should forget to think.
By giving liberty unto thine eyes. Examine other beauties.
'Tis the way to call her exquisite in question more. He that is stricken blind cannot forget the precious treasure of his eyesight lost. Show me another mistress that is passing fair. What doth her beauty serve but as a note where I may read who passed that passing fair? Farewell, Gus. Thou canst not teach me to forget.
I'll pay that doctor, else die in debt.
Of honorable reckoning are you both, and pity 'tis you lived at odds so long. But now, my lord, what say you to my suit?
But say, Nora, what I have said before. My child is yet a stranger in the world. She hath not seen a change of 14 years. Let 2 summers wither in their pride, ere we may think her ripe to be a bride.
Younger than she are happy mothers made.
And too soon marred, although so early made. The earth hath swaddled all my hopes, but she is a hopeful lady of my earth. But woo her, gentle Paris. Get her heart. My will to her consent is but a part, and she agree within her scope of choice. That's my consent in fair according voice. This night I hold an old accustomed feast, where to have invited many a guest, such as I love, and you among the store. One more most welcome makes my number more. Come, go with me. Sirrah, trench about you fair Verona. Found out these persons whose names are written there, and to them say, my house, and welcome on their pleasure stay.
Find them out whose names are written there? It is written that the shoemaker should meddle with his yard, the tailor with his last, the fisher with his pencil, and the painter with his net, but I am sent to find whose names are written here? And I can never find the names the writing person hath here writ. I must to the learned, in good time.
Tuts, man, one fire burns out, another's burning. One pain is lessened by another's anguish. Turn giddy and behold my back returning. One desperate grief cures with another's language. Take thou some new infection to thy eye, and the rank poison of the old will die.
Your plantain leaf is excellent for that.
For what, I pray thee?
For your broken chin.
But Romeo, art thou mad?
Not mad, but bound more than a madman is. shut up in prison, kept without my food, whipped and tormented and...
Got in, good fellow.
Got you got in. I pray, sir, can you read?
Aye, mine own fortune and my misery.
Well, perhaps you have learned it without book. But I pray you, sir, can you read anything you see?
Aye, if I know the letters and the language.
You say honestly, rest you merry.
Stay, fellow. I can read. Signor Placentio and his wife and daughters. County and Selma and his beauteous sisters. The white lady widow of Vitruvio. Mercutio and his brother Valentine. My uncle Capulet, his wife and daughters. County and Selma and his beauteous sisters. My fair niece, Rosalind. And Livia. A fair assembly. Whither should they come?
Up.
Whither?
To supper, to our house.
Whose house?
My master's.
Indeed, I should have asked thee that before.
Well, now I shall tell you without asking. My master is a great rich Capulet. And if you not be of the house of Montague, I pray thee, come and crush a cup of wine. Rest you merry.
At this same ancient feast of Capulets, sups the fair Rosaline, whom thou so lovest. Go thither, and with honor take to die. Compare her face with some I shall show, and I shall make thee think thy swan a crow.
One fairer than my love? The all-seeing sun ne'er saw her match since first the world begun.
Tat, you saw her fair none else being by. Herself poised with herself in either eye. But in that crystal scales that three weighed your lady's love against some other maid that I will show you shining at this feast. She will scant show well that now seems best.
I will go along. No such sight to be shown, but to rejoice in the splendor of mine own.
Romeo.
Come to an hour.
She's not 14.
Well, they're 14 and 15. And yet to my teen be it spoken, I have but four. She's not 14. How long is it now to Lammastide?
A fortnight and odd days.
Even a rod of all the days of the year, come Lammas Eve at night, shall she be 14. Susan and she, God rest all Christian souls, were of an age. Well, Susan is with God now. She was too good for me. But, as I said, come Lammas Eve at night, shall she be 14. Very that shall she, I remember it well. Tis since the earthquake now 11 years and she was weaned. I shall never forget it. Of all the days of the year, upon that day, my lord, you were dead. That shall
I. Enough of this, I pray thee, hold thy peace. Faith, I have done my mother to his grace.
Thou wast the prettiest babe that e'er I nursed, and I might think to see thee first married once, I have my word.
Mary, that Mary is the very theme I came to talk of. Tell me, Dr. Juliet, how stands your disposition to be married?
Well, it is an honor that I dream not of.
Well, think of marriage now. Why, here in Verona, younger than has no less.
No less? Nay, bigger. Women grow by men. Speak briefly.
Can you like a purse, love?
Well, I look to like if looking like the moon. But no more deep lines out my knife than your consent gives strength, make it fly.
Madam! The guests are come, supper is served. My young lady asked for, you called. The nurse cursed in the pantry, and everything is in extremity. I must hence to wait, I beseech you. Follow straight.
We follow thee.
Juliet, the country stays.
Go, girl. Seek happy nights to happy days.
By what they will. We'll measure them a measure and be gone.
Give me the torch. I'm not for this ambling. Being but heavy, I will bear the light.
Hey, gentle Romeo, we must have you down.
Not I, believe me. You have shoes with little soles. I have a soul of lead, so it stakes me to the ground. I cannot move.
You, sir, are a lover. Borrow Cupid's wings and soar with them above a common bound.
I am too sore and pierced with his shaft to soar with his light feathers. And so bound, I cannot bound a pitch above dull woe. Under love's heavy burden do I sink.
And to think in it, you should burden love's too great oppression for such a tender thing.
Is love a tender thing? It is too rough, too rude, too boisterous, and it pricks like a thorn.
If love be rough with you, be rough with love. And be a case for my visage. A visor for a visor. What care I? What curious eye doth court deformities? Here the beetle brow shall blush for me. Come, knock and answer, and note sooner in that every man betake him to his legs. Come along, Rome.
Give me the light. Let wanton's light apart, tickle the senseless rushes with their heels. For I am proverb the grandsire phrase. I'll be a candle holder and look on. The game was ne'er so fair. Oh, and I am done.
Ah, done's the mouse in the constable's own words. If thou art done, we'll draw thee from the mire wherein thou stickst up to the ears. Come, we burn daylight, ho! Oh.
Nay, that's not so.
I mean, sir, we waste our lights in vain like lamps by day. Take our good judgment, for our meaning sits five times higher than once our five wits.
And we mean well in going to this mask. But 'tis no wit to go.
And why, may one ask?
I dreamed the dream tonight.
And so did I.
Well, what was your dream?
That dreamers often lie.
In bed asleep while they do dream things true.
Oh, then I see Queen Mab have been with you. She is the fairy's midwife. She comes in shape no bigger than an agate stone athwart the forefinger of an elf, drawn by a little team of atomies athwart men's noses as they lie asleep. Her wagon spokes are made of the long spinner's legs. Her covers of the wings of grasshoppers. Her traces of the smallest spider's web. And her collars of the moonshine's watery beams. Her whip of cricket's spawn, lash of fin. Her wagoner is a small gray-coated gnat,
not half so big as a round little worm, pricked by the lazy finger of the maid. Her chariot is an empty hazelnut made by the joiner squirrel or old the grub. And her fairy's coachmakers, time out of mind, gallops in a state of mind through lover's brains and then dreams he of love. A courtier's knees that dream on courtesy straight, or lawyer's fingers who dream straight on keys, or lady's lips who straight dream on kisses, which oft the angry have with blisters plagues because of their breath with sweet meats tainted are. Sometimes she driveth over her soldier's neck, and then dreams he of cutting foreign throats, of breeches, of ambusculos, of Spanish blades, of heels 5 fathom deep, and then anon thrums in his ear, at which he stops and wakes. Thus frightened, swears a prayer or two, and sleeps again. This is she.
Peace, Mercutio. Now thou talkst of nothing.
True. I talk of dreams, which are the children of an idle brain, begot of nothing but vain fantasy, which is thin as substance as the air, and more inconstant than the wind, who woos even now the frozen bosom of the north. And thus being angered, puffs away from thence, turning his head to the dew-dropping south.
This wind you talk of blows us from ourselves. Supper is done, and no sooner in than every man be taken to his legs.
Let's go.
I fear too early. For my mind, this fears some consequence contained in the stars. Shall bitterly begin his fruitful day with this night's revels, and expire the term of despised life, closed in my breast, by some vile forfeit of untimely death. But he that hath the sturge of my course, direct my sail. On, lusty gentlemen!
Grindstone and Nell, Anthony and Potpan.
Aye, boy, ready.
You are looked for and called for and asked for and sought for in the great chamber.
We cannot be here and there too. Cheery, boys, for the longest liver takes off.
Thank you.
for sport comes well. Nay, sit, good cousin Capulet, for we are past our dancing days. How long is now since last yourself and I were in a match?
By her lady, 30 years.
What, man? Is not so much. This since the nuptial of Lucentio. Come Pentecost, as quickly as it will, some 25 years, and then we match.
Tis more. His son is elder, sir. His son is 30.
Well, you tell me that. His son was but a ward 2 years ago.
What lady is that which doth enrich the hand of yonder knight?
I know not, sir.
She doth teach the torches to burn bright. It seems she hangs upon the cheek of night, like a rich jewel beneath the oak's ear. Beauty too rich for use, the glory too dim. So shows this snowy dove trooping with crows, as yonder lady o'er her fellow shows. The measure done, I'll watch her place of stand. Touching hers may wound my blessed hand. My heart loved till now, forswear its night, for I ne'er saw true beauty till this night.
This, by his voice, should be in much. Fetch me my rapier, boy. What dares this slave come hither, cover with an ended face? Scorn our solemnity. Now, by the stock of my hand, to strike him dead, I will let us sit.
Why now, young kinsman, where do you storm yourself?
Uncle, this is the march of you, our home. A villain that is hither come in spite. To scorn our solemnity this night.
Young Romeo, is it?
Tis he, that villain Romeo.
Content thee, Justice Christ, let him alone. He bears him like a worthy gentleman, to say truth, for in a brag's meant to be a virtuous and well-governed youth. I would not for the wealth of all this town, here in my house, do him disparage me. Therefore, be patient, take no note of him. 'Tis my will, the which if thou respect, show a fair presence and put off these frowns, and it'll be seeming semblance for a feast.
It fits with such a villain as a guest. I'll not endure him.
He shall be endured. What, goodman boy, I say he shall. Go to. Am I the master here or you? You'll not endure him. God shall mend my soul. You'll make a mutiny among my guests. You'll set a cock-a-hoop. You'll be the man.
Why, uncle, tis a shame.
Go to. You are a saucy boy. If so, indeed, this trick may chance to scathe you. I know what. You must contrary me.
Good evening, Sir Captain.
Merry, tis time. Well said, my heart. You are a princox, go! Be quiet, or... Certainly, more life! For shame, I'll make you quiet! What?
Come, sir, won't you join our company?
Cheerly, my heart.
Patience, Burton Force, with willful collar meeting, makes my flesh tremble in their different greeting. I will withdraw this occasion, shall. Now seeming sweet and innocent, convert to bitterest gall.
Come, musicians, play!
Present effect I take. Thus, for my
by thine my sin is purged.
Oh, then have my lips the sin that they have took.
The sin from my lips? No, trespass sweetly urged. Give me my sin again.
You kiss by the book. Madam, your mother craves a word with you.
What is her mother?
Very bad, sir. Her mother is the lady of the house, and a good lady, and a wise and a virtuous. I don't know that you talk with all. I tell you, he that can lay hold of her shall be in the chink.
Is she a Capulet? Dear Count, my life is my foe's debt.
Romeo, away be gone. The sport is at its best.
Aye, so I fear. The more is my unrest.
Nay, gentlemen, prepare not to be gone. We have a trifling foolish banquet to order. Is it e'en so? Why, then I thank you all. I thank you, honest gentlemen. Good night. More torches here. Come on, then, let's to bed. Sirrah, by my faith, why is this late? I'll do my rest.
Oh, come here, the nurse. What is yon gentleman? The son and heir of old Tiberio. And what is he who is going out of town? Nary, that I think be young Petruchio. And what is he who follows there that will not dance? I know not. Go ask his name. Oh, if he be married, my grave is like my bridal bed. His name is Romeo, and the Montague, the only son of your great enemy. Oh, my only love sprung from my only hate. Too soon, too early, and now too late. How prodigious birth of love it is to me that I must love a loathed enemy. What's this? What's this? A rhyme I learned even now of one I danced with all. Juliet! Anon! Come, let's away. The strangers are all gone.
I go forward, but my heart is here. Oh, turn back, dull earth, and find thy center out.
Romeo, 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 Romeo
Mercutio.
Nay, I'll conjure too. Romeo! Humors! Madman! Passion! Lover! Appear thou in the likeness of a sigh? Speak but one rhyme and I am satisfied. Cry, but I mean, pronounce but love, and
dove.
Not in thy likeness, thou appear to us. Hear it not. He stirreth not. He moveth not. The ape is dead. And I must conjure him. I conjure thee by Rosaline's bright eyes, by her high forehead and her scarlet lips.
And if he hear thee, thou wilt anger him.
My invocation is but fair an art, and in his mistress's name I conjure only but to raise up him.
Come, he hath hid himself among these trees to be consulted with the humorous knight. Blind is love that best befits the dark.
If love is blind, it cannot hit the mark. Oh, good night, Romeo. Out to my truckle bed. For this field bed is too cold for me to sleep. Come, shall we go?
Go then, before 'tis vain to seek him where he means not to be found.
Let us go.
Good night, Romeo.
Good night, Romeo.
Jest scars that never felt a wound. Soft. Light through yonder window breaks. Stand, Juliet, he's the sun. Arise, fair sun. Kill the envious moon who is already sick and pale with grief that thou her maid art far me out fair than she. Not her maid, since she is envious. Their best delivery is but sick and green, and men but fools to wear it. Cast it off. Tis my lady. Oh, tis my love. Oh, that she knew she... She speaks. Yet she says nothing. What of that? Her eye discourses. I will answer it. Oh, I am too bold. Not to me she speaks. Two of the fairest stars in all the heaven, having some business, do entreat her eyes to twinkle in their spheres till they return. What if her eyes were there, they in her head? The brightness of her cheek would shame those stars as daylight to the lamp. Her eye in heaven would through the airy region stream so bright that birds would sing and think it were not night. See how she leans her cheek upon her hand. Oh, that I were a glove upon that hand, that I might touch that cheek.
Why me?
She speaks. Oh, speak again, bright angel, for thou art as glorious to this night being o'er my head as the winged messenger of heaven unto the white upturned winged messengers of mortals that fall back and gaze on him when he bestrides the lazy painting clouds and sails upon the bosom of the air.
Oh, Romeo. Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name. Art thou a knight? Oh, but be sworn, my love, and I'll no longer be a captain.
Oh, shall I hear more? Shall I speak at this?
'Tis but thy name which is my enemy. But thou art thyself, and I'm not a Montague. What is Montague? 'Tis nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. Be some other name. And what is in a name? That which we call rose by any other name would smell as sweet. And so Romeo would, were he not Romeo called, retain that dear perfection which he owes without that title.
and I'll be new baptized. Henceforth, I never will be Romeo.
What man art thou that thus be screened in the night so stubbornest on thy counsel?
By a name I know not how to tell thee who I am. My name, dear saint, is hateful to myself because it is an enemy to thee. Had I have written, I would tear the word.
I have not yet drunk 100 words of thy tongue's utterings, and yet I know the sound. Art thou not Romeo? And a Montague?
Neither, fair saint, if either thee dislike.
But how camest thou hither? The orchard walls are high and hard to climb, and the place death, considering who thou art, if any of my kinsmen find thee here.
My love's like wings, and I o'erperch these walls. For stony limits cannot hold love out, and what love can do, that dares love attempt. Therefore thy kinsmen are no let to me.
But if they do see thee, they will murder thee.
There lies more peril in thine eye than 20 of their swords. Look thou betwixt, and I am proof against their enmity.
Oh, I would not for the world they saw thee here.
I have night's cloak to hide me from their eyes. And thou love me, let them find me here. My life were better ended by their hate than death proved by wanting of thy love.
By whose direction found'st thou out this place?
By love that first did prompt me to inquire. He lent me counsel, and I lent him eyes. I am no pilot, yet I would adventure for such merchandise.
Thou knowest the mask of night is on my face. Else would a maiden blush bepaint my cheek for that which thou hast heard me speak tonight. Fain would I dwell on more. Fain deny that I have spoke, but farewell compliment. Dost thou love me? I know that will say aye, and I will take thy word. Yet if thou swearest, thou mayst be this false. As love is perjury, they say Jove laughs. Love, pronounce it faithfully. If thou think'st I'm too easily won, I will frown and be perverse and say thee nay, so thou wilt woo. But else not for the world. Oh, in truth, fair Montague, I am too fond, and therefore thou mayest think my behavior right. But believe me, I will prove more true than those who have more cunning to be strange. For I should have been more strange, I must confess. Years ere I was aware of my true love's passion. Therefore, pardon me, and do not impute this yielding to light love which the dark night hath so discovered.
Lady, by yonder blessed moon, I swear, that tips with silver all these fruit tree tops.
Oh, swear not by the moon, the inconstant moon that monthly changes in her circled orb, lest thy love prove likewise variable.
What shall I swear by?
Well, do not swear at all. Thou wilt, swear thou by thyself, which is the god of my idolatry, that I believe thee.
My heart's dear love.
Oh, do not swear. Although I joy in thee, I have no joy in this contract tonight. It is too rash, too unadvised, too sudden, and too like the lightning which thou seest to be ere one says it lightens. Good night. Good night. But love may prove a beauteous flower when next we meet. Oh, good night. May dear repose and rest come to thy heart as that within my breast.
Won't thou leave me so unsatisfied?
What satisfaction canst thou have tonight?
In exchange of thy love, faithful thou for mine.
But I gave thee mine before thou didst request it. Oh, and I would it were to give again.
Which thou hast brought, for what purpose, love?
Well, but to be frank and give it thee again. And yet I wish but for the thing I have. My bounty is as boundless as the sea, and my love is deep. And the more I give thee, the more I have, for both are infinite.
You what?
I hear some noise from within. Oh, dear love, adieu.
night. All this is but a dream, too flattering sweet to be substantial.
Three words, dear Romeo, and it's good night indeed. If thy bent of love be honorable, and thy purpose marriage, send me word tomorrow by one that I'll procure to come to thee. Where and at what time you perform the rite, and I will follow thee, my lord, throughout the rest of the world. Madam, anon I come. Or if thou meet'st not well, well, I do beseech thee, by and by I come. To cease thy suit and leave me to my grief. Tomorrow will I send.
By my soul.
1,000 times, good night.
1,000 times the worse to want thy light. Love goes toward love as schoolboys from their books. But love from love toward school with heavy looks.
Romeo! Psst. Oh, for a falconer's voice to lure this castle gentle back again. Bondage is hoarse and may not speak aloud. Else will I tear the caper epilies and make her airy tongue more hoarse than mine a repetition of my Romeo's name.
'Tis my soul that calls upon my name. Thou silver sweet sound, lover's tongues by night, with like softest music to attending ears.
Romeo!
My sweet!
At what o'clock tomorrow shall I send for thee?
At the hour of 9.
Oh, I will not fail. 'Tis 20 years till then. Well, I have forgot why I did call thee back.
Let me stand here till thou remember it.
Well, I shall forget to have thee still stand here, remembering how I love thy company.
And I'll still stay, to have thee still forget. Forget you any other home but this.
Tis almost morning, and I would have thee gone, and yet no further than a wanton's word, who left it hotly from her hand, like a prisoner in his twisted gyves, to a silk thread plucks it back again, so ever loving, jealous of his liberty.
I would thy bird.
Oh, sweet, so would I, and yet I would kill thee with much cherishing. Good night. Parting is such sweet sorrow. I shall say good night till it be morrow.
Sleep dwell in thine eyes, peace in thy breast. Would I were thy peace and sleep so sweet to rest. Hence will I to my ghostly father's cell, his help to crave and my dear heart to tell.
Eastern cloud and streaks of light. Now where the sun advances burning eye, the day to cheer, and the night's dank dew to dry. I must have filled this osier cage of ours with baleful weeds and precious juiced flowers. Oh, Mickle, a powerful grace it lies in plants, herbs, stones, and their true qualities. For naught so vile that on the earth doth live, but to the earth some special good doth give. Within the infant rind of this small flower, poison hath residence and medicine power. With that, being smelled with that part, cheers each part. Being tasted, slays all senses with the heart. Two such opposed kings encamp them still, in man as well as herbs, grace, and rude will. And where the worser is predominant, full soon that canker death eats up that plant.
Good morrow, father.
Benedicite, young son, thy earliness doth me assure thou art abroad with some distemperature. Or if not, then here I hit it right. Our Romeo had not been in bed tonight.
The last was true. The sweeter rest was mine.
God pardon sin. Wast thou with Rosaline?
With Rosaline, my ghostly father? No. I had forgot that name, and that name's woe.
Well, that, my good son. But where hast thou been then?
I tell thee ere thou askest me again. I have been feasting with my enemy.
Be plain, my good son, and homely in thy grip. Riddling confession finds but riddling tricked.
Then plainly know, my heart's dear love is set on the fair daughter of rich Capulet. As mine on her, so hers is set on mine, and all combined. Save what thou must combine by holy marriage. When and where and how we met, we wooed and made exchange of vow. This I tell thee as we pass. But this I pray, that thou consent to marry us today.
Holy Saint Francis, what a change is here. Is Rosalind that thou didst love so dear, so soon forsaken? Then young men's love then lies not truly in their hearts, but in their eyes. Oh, yea, Su Maria, what a deal of brine hast thou washed thy sallow cheeks for Rosaline? How much salt water thrown away in waste to season love that of it doth not taste? The sun, not yet thy sighs from heaven clears, thy old groans still ring in mine ancient tears. Lo, here upon thy cheek the stain doth sit of an old tear that is not washed off yet. If e'er thou wast thyself in these woes thine, thou in these woes were all for Rosaline. And art thou changed? Pronounce his sentence then. Women may fall when there's no strength in men.
Then chase me after loving Rosaline.
Oh, don't he? Not for loving, pupil mine.
And that's me very love.
Not in a grave to lay one in, another out to have.
I pray thee, chide not. She whom I love now doth grace and love for love allow. The other did not so.
Oh, she knew well. Thy love did breathe by rote and could not spell. But come, young weaver, come go with me. In one respect all thy sister be, for this alliance may so happy prove, to turn your household's rancor to pure love.
Oh, let us hence. I stand on sudden haste.
And wisely and slow, they stumble that run fast.
What devil is this, Romeo?
Came he not home tonight?
Not to his father's. I spoke of this man.
Ah, the same pale, hard-hearted wench, that Rosaline. She torments him so that he will sure run mad.
Tybalt, the kinsman told Capulet, hath sent a letter to his father's house.
A challenge? On my life.
Romeo will answer it.
Any man that can write may answer a letter.
Nay, Romeo will answer the letter's master. How he dares being dared.
Alas. Poor Romeo was already dead, stabbed with the white wench's black eye, shot through the ear with love's song. The very pin of his heart cleft to the blind bow of his buttshot. And is he a man to encounter Tybalt?
Why? What is Tybalt?
More than the Prince of Cats, I can tell you. He fights as you see. He keeps time, distance, and proportion. Rest me his minute rest. One, two, and the third in your bosom. Is the very butcher of a silk button. A duelist. A gentleman of the very first house of the first and second cause. Ah, the immortal passado, the punto reversal, the hut.
Oh, here comes Romeo.
Without his robe, like a dried hair. Oh, flesh. How art thou, fish-fire? Signor Romeo, bonjour. There's a French salutation for your French schlop. You gave us the counterfeit early last night.
Good morrow to you all.
What counterfeit did I give you?
The slip, sir, the slip. Can you not conceive?
Good Mercutio, my business was great, and in any such a case as mine, a man may strain courtesy.
That's as much as to say, as such a case as yours constrains a man to bow in the hands.
Meaning to curtsy.
Thou hast most kindly hit it.
A most courteous exposition.
Oh, nay, I am the very pink of courtesy.
Pink for flower?
Right.
Well, then is my pump well flowered?
Oh, well said, well said. Now follow me this jest till thy pump is worn, that when the single sole of it is worn, the jest may remain after wearing solely singular.
Single sole jest, solely singular. For the singleness.
Oh, come between us, good Benfolio, for my wit's bait.
Switching spurs, raw color match.
Why? Is this not better than groaning for love? Now art thou social. Now art thou Romeo.
Here comes goodly gear.
To hide her face, for her man the fairer face.
God ye good woman, gentlewoman.
God ye good then, fair gentlewoman.
Can any of you tell me where I may find the young Romeo?
I can tell you, but young Romeo will be older when you have found him than he was when you sought him. I am the youngest of that name, for fault of the worse.
You say well.
You say well, rest you merry. Wisely, wisely.
If you be he, I desire some confidence with you.
She will indict him to some supper.
Romeo, will you to your father's will to dinner thither?
I will follow.
Farewell, ancient lady.
Gentleman, nurse, who loves to hear himself talk, and will speak more in a minute than he will stand to in a month.
If he speak anything against me, I'll take him down! You are lustier than he is in 20 such jicks! If I cannot, I shall find those that shall! None of his flirt gills, and none of his stage mates! And thou must stand by and suffer every day to use me at his pleasure!
I saw no man use you at his pleasure. Why, if I had my weapon, should quickly have been out. I warrant you, I dare draw as soon as I see occasion in a good quarrel, and the law on my side.
Now, oh God, I am so vexed that every part of me quivers! Scar me now!
Pray you, sir, a word. And as I said, my young lady bid me inquire you out. What she bid me say, I will keep to myself. But let me tell you, if he should lead her into a fool's paradise, as they say, it would a very gross kind of behavior, as they say. For the gentlewoman is young, and if you should deal double with her, it were an ill thing to be offered of any gentlewoman, and a very weak dealing.
Nurse, commend me to thy lady and mistress. I protest unto thee.
With heart and faith, I will tell her as much. Lord, Lord, she will be a joyful woman.
What wilt thou tell her? Thou dost not mock me.
I will tell her, sir, that you do protest, which, as I take it, is a gentlemanlike offer.
Bid her device some means to come to ship this afternoon, and there she shall, at Friar Lawrence's cell, be shrived and married. Here's for thy pains.
Oh, truly, sir, not a penny.
Go to, I say you shall.
Well, this afternoon, she shall be there.
Nurse, commend me to thy lady.
Aye, a thousand times. Peter?
Anon.
My fan, Peter. And go before, and a pace.
Thank you.
chance she cannot meet him. Oh, that sounds so. Oh, she is lame. Well, love perish should be thought to 10 times faster glide than sun's beams, driving back shadows over lowering hills. And therefore do nimble pinions outstrong love. And therefore hath love swift cupid wings. Now the sun is upon highmost hill. And from 9 to 12, his 3 long hours yet she is not come. Well, had she affections and warm youthful blood, she would be as swift in motion as a ball. And my words would bandy her to my love and his to me. Oh, but old folks, for many feign as if they were dead, unwieldy, slow, heavy, and pale as lead. Oh, by my bones. Oh, God, she comes. Oh, honey, there's what news. And hast thou met with him? Send thy man away.
Peter, stay at the gate.
Now, good nurse, what news? Oh, why lookest thou sad? Although news be sad, yet tell them merrily. And if good, thou shamest the music of sweet news with so sour a face.
Oh, I am weary. Give me a while. Oh, I'm back. Oh, what a jaunt I've had.
Well, I would thou had my bones and I thy news. Come, speak, good nurse, speak.
Here's what haste. Stay a while. Do you not see I am out of breath?
Well, how art thou out of breath when thou hast breath to say to me that thou art out of breath? The excuse that thou dost use in this delay is longer than the tale which thou dost excuse. Is't good or bad? Answer to that. Well, say either, and I'll the circumstance. Come, let me be satisfied. Is't good or bad?
Well. You have made simple choice. You know not how to choose a man. Romeo, know not me. Though his face be better than any other man's, though his leg excels all other men's, and for a hand and a foot and a body, though they be not to be talked on, yet they are past compare. He's not the flower of courtesy. Thus I'll warrant him as gentle as a lamb. Go thy ways, wench, so God. What are you dining on?
No. No, but all this did I know before. But what says he of our marriage? What of that?
Lord, how my head aches. Oh, what a head have I. It beats as if it fall in 20 pieces. Oh, my back. Oh, the other side, my back. Beshrew your heart for sending me about to catch my death with jouncing up and down.
Oh, ay, faith, I am sorry that thou art not well. Sweet, sweet, sweet nurse. Tell me, what says Romeo?
Your love says, like an honest gentleman, courteous and a kind, and I warrant a virtuous. Where's your mother?
Where's my mother? Why, she's within. Where should she be? How oddly thou dost reply. Your love says, like an honest gentleman, where's my mother?
God's lady, dear, are you so hot? Mary, come up, my trout. Is this the poultice for my aching bones? Henceforward, do your messages yourself.
Oh, here's such a coil. Come, what says Romeo?
Have you got leave to go to shoot today?
I have.
Yes. Hie you hence to Friar Lawrence's cell. There stays a husband to make your wife. Now comes the wanton blood up in your cheeks. There be it scarlet straight in any hues. I'm to church. I must another way to fetch a ladder by the which your love must climb his bird's nest soon when it is dark. I am the drudge in toil and your delight. But you shall bear the burden soon at night. Go, hide to the cell. Hide to dinner.
Hide to high fortune, honest nurse. Farewell.
Their violent ends, and in their triumph die like fire and hell. Amen. Amen.
But come what sorrow can,
It cannot countervail the exchange of joy that one short minute gives me in her sight. Do thou but close our hands in 40 words. The love-devouring death, do what he dare. It is enough. I may but call her mine.
These violent ends may die like fire and powder, which as they kiss, consume. The sweetest honey is loathsome in its own deliciousness, and in the taste confounds the appetite. Therefore, love moderately, long love doth so. Too swift a rise is tardy as too slow. Here comes a lady, oh, so light a foot where there were out the everlasting flint. A lover may bestride the gossamer that idles in the wanton summer air and yet not fall. So light is vanity.
Oh, good even to my ghostly confessor.
Romeo shall thank thee, daughter, for us both.
And else to him, else is his thanks too much.
Juliet, if the measure of thy joy be heat like mine, and that thy skill be more to blazon in it, and sweeten with thy breath this neighbor, and let rich music's tone unfold the imagined happiness that both receiving either by this dear encounter.
It seems more rich in matter than in words, rags of substance, and not of ornament. Oh, they are but beggars that can count their worth. But my love has grown to such excess that I can't sum up some of half my wealth.
Come, come with me, and we will make short work. For by your leaves you shall not stay alone, till Holy Church incorporate two in one.
We shall not escape abroad. For now these hot days the mad blood stirring.
Thou art like one of these fellows, that when he enters the confines of a tavern, claps me his sword upon the table and says, God send me no need of thee. And by the operation of the second cup, draws it on the jar, when indeed there is no need.
Am I like such a fellow?
Come, come, thou art as hot a jack in thy mood as any in Italy. And as soon moved to be moody, and as soon moody to be moved.
And what two?
Nay, and there were two such. Oh, we should have none, surely, for one would kill the other. Thou wast quarrel with a man, having a hair more or hair less on his beard than thou hast. Thou hast quarreled with a man for coughing in the streets, because he has awakened thy dog laying asleep under the sun. Didst thou not fall out of the tailor for wearing his new doublet before Easter? And yet another for wearing his old shoes with new ribbon? And yet thou wilt tutor me from quarreling.
And if I were so apt to quarrel as thou art, any man should buy the fee simple of my life for an hour and a quarter.
The fee simple? Oh, simple.
By my head, here come the Capulet.
By my heel, I care not.
Follow me close, for I will speak to them.
Gentlemen, good den. A word with one of you.
And but a word with one of us. Couple it with something. Make it a word and a blow.
You shall find me apt enough to that, sir. And you will give me occasion.
Can you not take some occasion without giving?
Mercutio, thou consortest with Romeo.
Consort? What? Dost thou make us minstrels? And to make us minstrels, you should look to hear nothing but the scores. Here's my fiddlestick. Here's that shall make you dance. Zounds, consort.
Gentlemen, here we talk in the public haunt of men. Either withdraw us into some private place and reason coldly of our grievances, else depart. Here all eyes gaze on us.
Men's eyes are made to look, and let them gaze. I will not budge, for no man's pleasure I.
Peace with you, sir. Here comes my man.
And I'll be hanged, sir, if you wear your livery. Marry, go before to Peel. He'll be your follower, your worship in that sense, may call him man.
Romeo, the hate, I bear thee can afford. No better term than this. Thou art a villain.
The reason that I have to love thee doth much excuse the appertaining race to such a greedy. Villain am I none. Farewell. I see thou knowest me not.
Boy! This shall not excuse the injuries that thou hast done me. Therefore, turn and draw.
Tybalt, I do protest I never injured thee, but love thee better than thou canst devise till thou shalt know the meaning of my love. And so, good Capulet, which name I tender as dearly as mine own, satisfied.
Oh, calm, vile, dishonorable submission. A staccato carries it away. Tybalt, you rat catcher, will you walk?
What wouldst thou have with me?
Nothing, good king of cats, but one of your nine lives that I wish to make bold withal. And as you shall use me hereafter, drive deep the rest of the eight. Will you pull your sword out of its pouch by the ears? Make haste, this morning be about your ears, ire it be out.
I am for you.
Gentle Mercutio, put thy rapier up.
Come, sir, your posada.
Draw, Benvolio. Beat down your weapon.
Gentlemen.
For shame, forbear this outrage. Mercutio, Tybalt. The prince expressly has forbid his bandit to go to sleep. Tybalt, for shameful bandit outrage. Hold, Tybalt, good Mercutio.
Oh, I am hurt. Oh, plague of all the isles. Gone and hath nothing?
What? Art thou hurt?
Aye, aye. A scratch, a scratch. Mary, 'tis enough to serve. Where is my man? Go, villain, fetch a surgeon.
Courage, man, the hurt cannot be much.
It's not so deep as a well, nor as wide as a church door, but 'tis enough. Ask for me tomorrow, and you shall find me a grave man. Oh, I'm peppered. I want for this world. Oh, plague of all your houses. Dog, a rat, a mouse, a cat, you scratch a man to death. Oh, a braggart, the rogue that fights by the book of arithmetic. Why the devil came you between us? I was hurt under your arm.
I thought all for the best.
Come, Benvolio, take me into some house or I shall faint. A plague of all your houses. They have made worms meat of me. I have it, and soundly too. Your houses.
This gentleman, the prince's near ally, my very friend, hath got this mortal hurt in my behalf. my reputation stained with Tybalt's slander. Oh, sweet Juliet, thy beauty hath made me effeminate, and in my temper softened valor steel.
Unjust Romeo. Brave Mercutio is dead. Now the spirit which had inspired the clouds, which to one time the heron had scorned the earth.
This day, black fate, on more days doth be bent. This but begins the woe, others must end.
Here comes that furious Tybalt back again.
Alive in triumph, and Mercutio slain. Away to heaven, respect divinity, and fire-eyed fury be my conduct now. Now, Tybalt, take the villain back again which thou layst gave me. For Mercutio's soul is but a little way above our heads. Stay for thine to keep him company. Either thou or I, or both, must go with him.
Thou wretched boy that didst consort him here, shalt whip him hence.
This shall determine that.
Romeo, away, be gone. The citizens are up in Tybalt's lane. The prince will doom thee to death if thou art taken. Be gone, away.
I am fortune's fool.
Why dost thou stand?
Which way ran he that killed Mercutio? Tybalt, that murderer? Which way ran he?
There lies that Tybalt.
Up, sir, go with me. I charge thee in the prince's name, obey!
There lies that man, slain by young Romeo, that slew thy kinsman brave Mercutio.
Tybalt, my cousin, oh my brother's child, oh prince, oh cousin, husband, now the blood is spilt of our dear kinsman. Prince, as thou art true, the blood of ours, shed blood of Montague, oh cousin.
In Polio. Who began this bloody fray?
Tybalt, there slain, whom Romeo's hand did slay. Romeo that spoke in fair, bid it bethink how nice the poor was, nourished with all your high displeasure. All this uttered with a gentle breath, calm look. These humbly bowed could not take truce with the unruly spleen of Tybalt, deaf to peace. But then he tilts with piercing steel and full Mercutio's breast. Who all his heart turns deadly point to point, and with one hand beats aside cold death, and with the other sends it back to Tybalt, whose dexterity retorts it. Romeo, he cries, hold, friends! Friends, part! But in the instant came fire. The brave Mercutio was slain, and Tybalt fled. But by and by comes back again to Romeo, who had but newly entertained revenge. And to it they go like lightning. For ere I could draw to part them was stout Tybalt slain. And as he fell did Romeo turn and fly. This be the truth. Will not Benvolio die?
He is a kinsman to the Montague. Affection makes him false. He speaks not truth. Some 20 of them fought this black stripe, and all those 20 could be killed.
thou prince must give. Romeo slew Tybalt. Romeo must not live.
Romeo slew him. He slew Mercutio, who now the price of his dear blood doth owe.
Not Romeo, prince. It was Mercutio's friend. His fault concludes with the law should end, the life of Tybalt.
And for that offense, we do exile him hence. I have an interest in your hate proceeding. My blood for your rude brawls doth lie a-bleeding. But I'll immerse you with so strong a finding, you shall all repent the loss of mine. I would be deaf to clear any excuses. Nor tears nor prayers shall purchase out abuses. Therefore, use none. Let Romeo hence in haste, else when he has found that hour will be his last. Bear hence this body and attend our will. Mercy but murderers, pardoning those that kill.
Pace you, fiery-footed steeds, toward Phobius' lodging. Such a Wagner as Phaethon would whip you to the west and bring the cloudy light immediately. Come, night. Come, Romeo. Come, thou day and night. For thou wilt lie upon the wings of night, whiter than new snow on a raven's back. Come, gentle night. Come, loving black-browed night. Give me my Romeo, and when he shall die, take him and cut him up into little stars, and he will make the face of heaven so fine that all the world will be in love with night and pay no worship to the garish sun. Oh, I have bought the mansion of love, not yet possessed it, and though I am sold, have not yet enjoyed. Oh, so tedious is this day. As is the night of a festival to an impatient child who hath new robes and may not wear them. Oh, here comes my nurse, and she brings news, and every tongue that speaks but my Romeo's name speaks of heavenly eloquence. How now, nurse? Oh, what hast thou there? The cords that Romeo did bid thee fetch.
Aye, the cords.
Come now, what news? Why dost thou wring thy hands?
Oh, alack the day. He's dead, he's dead, he's dead. We are undone, Delia, we are undone. He's gone, he's killed, he's dead.
Who can heaven be so envious?
Oh, Romeo, can no heaven can. Oh, Romeo, Romeo, well! Parton, your Romeo will be here at night. Adrian, he is here at Lawrence cell.
Oh, find him. Find him. Give this ring to my true knight and bid him come and take his last farewell.
For the prince's doom.
What less than doomsday is the prince's doom?
A gentler judgment vanished from his lips. Not Baldi's death, but Baldi's banishment.
Banishment? Be merciful, say death.
For exile hath more tear in his eye, much more than death.
Do not say banishment.
Hence from Verona art thou banishing. Be patient, for the world is broad and wide.
There is no world without Verona walls. But purgatory, torture, hell itself. And banishing is banished from the world, and world's exile is death.
That banishing is death, mister.
Oh, calling death banishment, thou cut my hand with a golden axe and smiles upon the stroke that murders me.
Oh, deadly sin. Oh, rude unthankfulness. Thy fault, our laws call death. But the kind prince, taking thy part, hath rushed aside the law and turned that black word death to banishment. This is dear mercy, and thou seest it not.
Tis torture, not mercy. Heaven is here where Juliet lives, and every cat and dog and little bird, every little mouse, every unworthy thing live here in heaven and may look on her. But Romeo may not. More validity, more cogent, more honorable state and carrion flies than Romeo. They may seize in the white wonder of dear Juliet's hand, and steal immortal blessings from her lips. Who, even in pure and mystical modesty, still blushes thinking their own kisses sin. But Romeo may not even banish. His name flies do. But I from this must fly. Oh, they are free men, but I am banishing. And sayest thou yet that exile is worse than death? Oh, hast thou no poison mixed, no sharp down knife, no sudden mean of death, though ne'er so mean? Then banish it to kill me. Banish it. Oh, fire, the damned use of that word in hell, howling attends it. How hast thou the heart? Being a divine, a ghostly confessor, a sin absolver, and my friend professed to mangle me with that word, banish it.
Thou born bad man, hear me but speak a word.
Oh, thou wilt speak of banishment.
I'll give thee armor to keep off that word. Adversity sweet to philosophy, to comfort thee, though thou art banished.
Yet banish it. Ain't no philosophy, unless philosophy can make a Juliet. This planet town reverse the prince's doom. It helps not, it prevails not, talk no more.
Oh, that I see that madmen have no ears.
Oh, that I see that wise men have no eyes.
Let me dispute with thee of thy estate.
Thou canst not speak of that which thou dost not feel. Wert thou as young as I, Juliet thy love, an hour but merry, Tybalt murder, doting like me, and like me banish it. Then mightst thou speak. Then mightst thou tear thy hair and fall upon the ground as I do now, taking the measure of an unmade grave.
Arise, nose! Good Romeo, hide thyself!
Oh, my tie, as the heart of his groans, mislike and fold me from the search of eyes.
Oh, hark, how they knock! Who's there? Romeo, arise, thou wilt be taken! Stay a while! Stand up! Run to my study! Fine, fine! God's will, what simpleness is this?
own tears made drunk.
Oh, even he's in my tears. It's just my case.
Oh, woeful sympathy. Piteous predicament.
Even so lies she, blubbering and weeping and blubbering. Stand up. Stand up. Stand and you'll be a man. For Juliet's sake. For her sake, rise and stand. Why should you fall into so deep an hole?
Yes.
Sir, death, the end of all.
Speak so, Juliet. How is it with her? Does not she think me an old murderer? Now I have stained the childhood of our joy, with blood removed but little from her own. How is she and how doth she? What says my concealed lady to our cancelled love?
She says nothing. Falls on her bed, and weeps and weeps. And Tybalt calls, and then on Romeo cries, and then down falls again.
As a bad name. Shot from the deadly level of a gun. As if that name's cursed hand did murder her. Oh, tell me, Friar. Tell me. In what vile part of this anatomy doth my name lodge? Tell me that I may sack the hateful mansion!
Hold thy desperate hand! Art thou a man? Thy form cries out thou art! Thy tears are womanish! Thy wild acts denote the unreasonable fury of a beast! Hast thou slain Tybalt? Wilt thou slay thyself and slay the lady too that lives in thee by doing this damned hate upon thyself? What roused thee, man? Thy Juliet is alive, for whose dear sake thou wast but lately dead. Then, art thou happy? Tybalt would slay thee, but thou slewest Tybalt. There art thou happy too. The law, the threatened death, becomes thy friend and turns into exile. There art thou happy. A pack of blessings lies upon thy back. Happiness accords with thee in her best array. But like a misbehaved and sullen witch, thou pounderest upon thy love and thy fortune. Take heed, take heed. Such die miserable. Go. Get thee to thy love as was decreed. Ascend her chamber hence and comfort her. But look thou stay not till the watch be set, for then thou canst not pass to Mantua, where thou shalt live until we can find a time to blaze your marriage, reconcile your friends, beg pardon of the prince, and call thee back with 200,000 times more joy than thou wast forth in lamentation. Go before us. Commend me to thy lady, and bid her hasten all the house to bed which heavy sorrow makes them after the food. Romeo is coming.
Oh, Lord, I could have stayed here all the night to hear good counsel. Oh, what learning is. My lord, I will tell my lady you'll come.
Do so, and bid my sweet prepare to chide.
Yes, sir, a ring she bid me give you, sir. And you make haste, for it grows very late.
Well, my comfort is revived by this.
Go hence, and good night. And here stands all your state. Either be gone before the watch be set, or by the break of day disguise from hence. Sojourn in Mantua. I'll find out your man, and he shall signify from time to time every good hath a chance of here. Give me thy hand. 'Tis late. Good night, and farewell.
But then a joy past joy calls out on me. It were a grief so brief to part with thee. Farewell.
Things have fallen out, sir, so unluckily that we have had no time to move our daughter. Look you, she loved her kinsman Tybalt dearly. So did I, but we were born. It's very late. She'll not come down tonight. I promise you, but for your company, I would have been abed an hour ago.
These times of woe afford no time to lose. Madam, good night. Commend me to your daughter.
I will, and no reminder of me tomorrow. Tonight she's mewed up to her heaviness.
Sir Paris, I will make a desperate tender of my child's love. I think she will be ruled in all aspects by me. Nay more, I doubt it not. Wife, go you to Juliet ere you go to bed, and acquaint her here of my son Paris's love, and bid her mark you me on Wednesday next. But soft, what day is this?
Monday, my lord.
Monday? Oh, Wednesday is too soon. Oh, Thursday let it be. Oh, Thursday, fella, she will be married to this noble earl. Will you be ready? Do you like this haste? We'll keep no great ado, a friend or two. For hark you, Tybalt being slain so late, it may be thought that we held him carelessly, being our kinsmen if we revel much. Therefore, we'll have some half a dozen friends, and there and end. But what say you to Thursday?
My lord, I would that Thursday were tomorrow.
Well, get you gone. Oh, Thursday be it then. Go you to Juliet ere you go to bed. Prepare her, wife, against this wedding day. Farewell, my lord. Light to my chamber, ho, before me. It is very, very late, that we may call it early by and by. Good night.
The lark, the herald of the morn. No nightingale. Look, love, what envious streaks do lace the severing clouds in yonder east? Night's candles are burned out, and jocund day stands tiptoe on the misty mountaintops. I must be gone and live, or stay and die.
Yon light is not daylight, and no time. It is some meteor that the sun exhales to beat to thee on this night a torchbearer, and light thee on thy way to Mantua. Therefore stay it. Thou needs not to be gone.
Let me be ta'en. Let me be put to death. I am content, so thou wilt have it so. I'll say yon's grave's not the morning's eye. 'Tis but the pale reflex of Cynthia's brow. No, that is not the lark whose notes do beat the faulty heaven in heaven above our heads. I have more care to stay. Come, death, and welcome! Juliet wills it so. How is my soul? Let's talk, it's not day.
Oh, it is, it is. Oh, hide hence, be gone away. It is the lark that sings so out of tune, straining harsh discords and unpleasing shots. Some say the lark bears sweet division. This doth not so, for she divideth us. Some say the lark and the loath toad change eyes. Now I would they change voices too. Since on and on this voice doth us afraid, come to thee, hence hunts up to the day. Now be gone. More light and light it grows.
More light and light. More dark and dark our woes.
Madam, nurse, the Lady Mother is coming to your chamber. The day is here. Be wary. Look about.
Oh, then, window. Let day in, and let night out.
Farewell. Farewell. One kiss and I'll be safe.
shall be gone so long. Lord, my husband, friend, I must hear from thee every day in the hour, for in a minute there are many days. Oh, by this count, I shall be much in years ere again I beheld my Romeo.
Farewell. I will omit no opportunity to convey my greetings love to thee.
Oh, thinkest thou we shalt ever meet again?
I doubt it not. And all these woes shall serve for sweet discourses in our time to come.
Oh, God. I have an ill-divining soul. From methinks I see thee now. Thou art as one dead in the bottom of a tomb. And either my eyesight fails, or thou dost care.
And trust me, love. And my eyes still be you. Thy sorrow drinks our blood. Adieu.
Gentlemen, the gallant young and noble gentleman, the county Paris at St.
sunset of my brother's sun, it rains downright. How now, a conduit girl? What's still in tears, evermore charming? How now, wife? Have you delivered to her our decree?
Aye, sir, but she will none. She gives you thanks. I would the fool were married to her greatly.
Soft. Take me with you. Take me with you, wife. How? Will she none? Does she not give us thanks? Is she not proud? Does she not count her blessed, unworthy as she is, that we have brought so worthy a gentleman to be a bridegroom?
Well, not proud you have, but thankful that you have. Proud can I never be of what I hate. Thankful even for hate that is meant love.
How now, chop logic. What is this? Proud, and I thank you, and I thank you not. And yet not proud, Mistress Minnie and you. Thank me no thankings, nor proud me no proud. But fettle your fine joints against Thursday next to go with Paris to St. Peter's Church, for I will drag thee out on a hurdle thither. Out, you green sickness carrier! Out, you baggage, you tallow face!
Fie, fie, what are you, mad? Oh, good father, I beseech you on my knees. Hear me with patience, but to speak a word.
Hang thee, unbaggage, disobedient wretch! I tell thee what, get thee to a church on Thursday, or never after look me in the face. Speak not! Reply not, do not answer me. My fingers itch. Wife, we scarce thought us blessed that God had led us but this only child. But now I see this one is one too much, and that we have a curse in having her. Out on her! Tell me!
Oh, in heaven, bless her!
You are to blame, my lord, to rate her soul.
And why, my lady wisdom? Hold your tongue, good prudence. Matter your gossips, go! God, ye God, and...
Be not one speak!
Peace, you mumbling fool! Let your gravity our gossips fall, for here we need it not!
You are too hot.
God's bread, it makes me mad. Day, night, hour, tide, time, work, play. Alone in company still my care hath been to have her matched. And having now provided a gentleman of noble parentage, a fair demesis, youthfully and nobly trained, stopped, as they say, with honorable parts, proportioned as once thought would wish a man, and then to have a wretched, puny fool, a whining mammon and a fortune's tender to answer, I'll not wed, I cannot love, I am too young, I pray thee pardon me. But then you will not wed, I'll pardon you. Graze where you will, you shall not house with me. Look to, think on't, I do not use to jest. Thursday is near, lay hand on heart, advise. And you be mine, I'll give you to my friend. And you be not, hang, beg, starve, die in the street. For by my soul, I'll ne'er acknowledge thee. Nor what is mine shall ever do thee good. Trust to it, bethink you, I'll not be forsworn.
Oh, is there no pity sitting in the clouds above that can see into the bottoms of my grief? Oh, sweet my mother. Cast me not away. Delay this marriage a month, a week. Or if thou wilt not, but make my bridal bed in the dim monument where Tybalt lies.
Talk not to me, or I'll speak a word. Do as thou wilt, for I have done with thee.
Oh, God. Oh, nurse, how shall this be prevented? On earth and my faith in heaven. And how shall that faith return again to earth unless my husband sent it to me from heaven by leaving earth? Oh, comfort me. Counsel me. Oh, alack. Alack that heaven should practice such stratagems on such a soft subject as myself. What sayest thou? Hast thou not a word of joy? Some comfort, nurse.
Faith, here it is.
Amen. What? Well, thou hast helped me marvelous much. Go in and tell my lady I'm gone, having displeased my father to Lord's end, to make confession and to be absolved.
Mary, I will. This is my pretty daughter.
Angel, damnation! Oh, most wicked fiend! Is it more sin to wish me thus forsworn, or to dispraise the name of my Lord with the same tongue which thou didst praise above compare so many thousand times? Go, counselor, thou and my bosom henceforth shall be twain. What right to know his remedy? And if all else fail, myself have power to die!
Unevenness, of course, I like it not.
Immoderately she weeps for Tybalt's death. Therefore have I touched little of love, for Venus smiles not in a house of tears. Now, sir, her father counts it dangerous that she give her sorrow so much sway, and in his wisdom hastens our marriage, to stop the inundation of her tears, which too much minded by herself alone may be put from her by society. Now do you know the reason of this haste?
I would I knew not why it should be slow. The lady comes to herself.
Happily met, my lady and my wife.
That may be, sir, when I may be a wife.
That may be, must be, love, on Thursday next.
But what must be shall be.
That for certain can.
Come you to make confession to the scribe?
To answer to that, I must make confession to you.
Do not deny to him that you love me.
I will confess to you that I love him.
So will ye, I am sure, that you love me.
More of Christ being spoken behind your back rather than to your face.
Oh, soul, thy face is much of you, tears.
Oh, the tears have gotten small victory by that, for it was bad enough before their spite.
The wrong said more than tears with that report.
That is no slander, sir, which is the truth. And when I spake it to my face.
My face is mine, and thou hast slandered it.
Well, that may be, sir. For it is not mine own. Are you at leisure, holy father, now, or should I come to you at evening mass?
My leisure serves me, piece of daughter, now. My lord, we must entreat the time alone.
God shield, I should disturb devotion. Julia, Thursday early will I rouse you. Till then, adieu.
Shut the door, and when thou hast done so, come weep with me. Oh, past help, past cure, past hope.
Ah, Juliet, I already know thy grief. It strains me past the compass of my wits. I hear thou must in nothing make prorogate on Thursday next be married to this county.
Tell me not that thou hearest of this, unless thou tell me how I may prevent it. My resolution wise, and with this knife I shall help it presently. God joined my heart and Romeo's, and thou our hands. And ere this hand by thee to Romeo sealed shall be the label of another deed, or my true heart with treacherous revolt turn to another, this shall slay them both.
Hold, daughter, I do spy a kind of hope which craves as desperate an execution as which you would revenge. If rather than to marry County Paris, thou hast the strength of will to slay thyself, then it is likely thou wilt undertake a thing like death to chide away this shame, and
that copest with death himself escape from it. And if thou darest, I'll give thee remedy.
Oh, let me leap rather than marry Paris from off the battlements of yonder tower. Or walk in thievish ways. Or bid me lurk where serpents are. Chain me with roaring bears and lock me in a nightly charnel house. Or covered quite with dead men's rattling bones and reeky shanks and yellow chaff of skulls. Or bid me into a new-made grave. Hide me with the dead man in the shroud. To hear them told have made me tremble. And I will do it without fear or doubt, to live an unstained wife to my sweet love.
Hold then. Go home. Be merry. Give consent to marry Paris. Wednesday is tomorrow. Tomorrow night, look that thou lie alone. Let not thy nurse lie with thee in thy chamber. Take thou this line. Being then in bed, and this distilled liquor, drink thou off. When presently through all thy veins shall run a cold and drowsy humor. For no pulse shall keep its native progress, but surcease. No warmth, no breath shall testify thou livest. The roses in thy lips and cheeks will fade to pale ashes. Thy eyes as windows fall like death when he shuts up the day of light. Each part, deprived of supple government, shall stiff and stark and cold appear like death. And in that shrunken likeness of death, thou shalt continue 2 and 40 hours, and then awake as from a pleasant sleep. Now, when the bridegroom in the morning comes to rouse thee from thy bed, there art thou dead. Then, as the manner of our country is, and all thy best robes uncovered on the bear, thou shalt be borne to that same ancient vault where all the kindred of the captives lie. In the meantime against, shall Romeo, by my letters, know our drift, and hither shall he come, and he and I will watch thy waking. And that very night shall he bear thee hence to Mantua, and this shall free thee from this present shame, if no inconstant toy, no womanish fear abate the valor in the act in it.
Oh, give me, talk not to me of fear!
Oh. Here to go, be strong and prosperous in this resolve. I'll send a friar with speed to Mantua, with my letter to thy lord.
Oh, strength give help, and love help afford. Dear father, farewell.
So many guests and writers here already. Sirrah, go hire me 20 cunning cooks.
You shall have none ill, sir, for I'll try if they can lick their fingers.
How canst thou try them so?
Marry, sir, 'tis an ill cook that cannot lick his own fingers. Therefore, he that cannot lick his fingers goes not with me.
Go, be gone. Oh, we shall be much unfurnished for this time. What, is my daughter gone to see Friar Lawrence?
Aye, forsooth.
Well, you may chance to do some good on her.
See where she comes from straight with very little.
Oh, now, my headstrong, where have you been guiding?
Where I have learned of me to repent the sin of disobedient opposition. To you and your behest am I enjoined by Holy Lawrence to fall prostrate here and to beg your pardon. Pardon, I beseech you. Henceforward, I am ever ruled by you.
Send for the county. Go tell him of this. I'll have this knot knit up tomorrow morning.
I met the county at Lord Sir, and gave him what becomes love I might, or not stepping over the bounds of modesty.
Why, I am glad on't. This is well. Stand up. This is as it should be. Let me see the county. Harry, Mary, go, I say, and fetch him hither. Now, afore God, this reverend holy friar, our whole city is much bound to him.
Will you go with me to my closet and help me sort such needful ornaments as I'll think fit for tomorrow?
No, not till Thursday. There will be time enough.
Go, nurse, go with her. We'll to church tomorrow.
We shall be short in our provision. 'Tis now near night.
Gosh, I must stir about, and all things will be well. I warrant thee, wife. Go without me, Julia. Help to trim her up. I'm not to bed tonight. Let me alone. Let me play the housewife for this once. What ho? They're all four. Well, I walk myself to County Paris and prepare him up against this wedding day. My heart is wondrous light since the same wayward girl is so reclaimed.
pray thee leave me to myself tonight, for I have need of many oars and smooth the heavens to shine upon my state, which well thou knowest is the cross and full of sin.
What, are you busy, ho? Need you my help?
No, madam, we've called such necessaries as are behooved before tomorrow.
So please you,
leave me to myself, and let the nurse sit up with you this night, for I'm sure you have your hands full in all this so sudden business.
Good night. Get thee to bed and rest, for thou hast me.
Farewell. God knows we shall meet again. I have a faint cold fear thrills through my veins and almost freezes up the heat of life. Well, call them back again to comfort me. Nurse! And what should she do here? My dismal scene I needs must act alone. Come, Vile. And what if this mixture do not work at all? Shall I then be buried tomorrow morning? No! No, this shall forbid it! Vile. When I am laid in the tomb, I wake before the time that Romeo come to redeem me. Oh, there's a fearful point. Shall I then be stifled in the vault whose foul mouth no healthsome air breathes in, and then die strangled ere my Romeo comes? Or if I live, it is not very like the horrible conceit of death and night together with the terror of the place. As in a vault, ancient receptacle where for this many hundred years the bones of all my buried ancestors are packed. My bloody tilt, yet but green in earth, lies festering in his shroud. Whereas this day, at some hours of the night, spirits resort. Oh, alack, alack, it is the light that I can. So early waking, with what loathsome smells and shrieks like mandrakes torn out of the earth, when living mortals hearing them run mad. Oh, should I not be distraught and fired with all these hideous fears? And madly play with my forefather's joints, and pluck the mingled tumult from his shroud, and in these rages with some great kinsman bone dash up my desperate brains. Oh, look. Methinks me see me cousin's ghost thinking at Romeo. And did spit his body upon a rapier's point. Oh, stay, Tybalt, stay! Oh, Romeo, I come. This do I drink to thee.
Here with music straight, for so he said he would.
I hear him near. Nurse! Wife! What, ho? What, nurse, I say! Go waken Julia. Go and trim her up. I'll chat with Paris. I make haste. Make haste. The bridegroom, he has come already. Make haste, I say. Lies on her like an untimely frost upon the sweetest flower of all the field.
Oh, the miserable day, woeful time!
Death that hath taken her hence to make me well, ties up my tongue and will not let me speak.
Come, is the bride ready to go to church?
Ready to go, but never to return. Oh, son, the night before thy wedding day hath death lain with thy wife. See, there she lies, flower as she was, deflowered by him. Death is my son-in-law. Death is my heir. My daughter he hath wed. I will die and leave them all. Life, living, all is death.
If I thought long to see this morning's face, doth it give me such a sight as this?
Unhappy, wretched, hateful day, most miserable hour that ere time saw a lasting labor of his pilgrimage. But one, oh one, one poor and loving child, but one thing to rejoice and solace in, and cruel death hath snatched it from my sight.
Oh, woe, oh, woe, the woeful, woeful day, most lamentable day, most woeful day that ever either I did yet own. Oh, there was the day so black as this. Oh, day, oh, day, day, oh, hateful day. Oh, woeful, woeful day.
Begun, deformed, wrong, spited, slain. Detestable death by thee beguiled. Cruel, thee quite overthrown. Life, but love and death.
Despised, distressed, hated, martyred, killed. Oh, uncomfortable time. Why camest thou now to murder, murder our solemnity? My child, my child. My soul and not my child. Alack, child is dead. And with my child, all my joys are buried.
Peace. Oh, for shame. Confusion's cure lives not in these confusioner. Heaven and yourself had fought in this fair maid. And now heaven hath all. And all the better it is for the maid. Dry up your tears, and steep your rosemary on this fair corse. And as the custom is, in all her best array, bear her to church. For though fallen nature bids us all lament, yet nature's tears are reason's merriment.
All things reordained, festival, turn from the office black funeral. Our instruments to melancholy bells, our wedding cheer to a sad burial feast, our solemn hymns through sullen dirges change, our bridal flowers serve for buried cause, and all things change them to the contrary.
Sir, go your way. Everyone prepare to follow this fair course into a grave. The heavens do lower upon you for some ill. Move them no more by crossing there at will.
I may trust the flattering truth of sleep. My dreams presage some joyful news at hand. My bosom's lord sits lightly in his throne, and all this day an unaccustomed spirit lifts me above the ground with cheerful thoughts. I dream my lady came and found me dead. Strange dream that gives a dead man leave to think, and breathed such life with kisses in my lips that I revived and was an emperor. Ah, me. How sweet it so is love possessed when but love's shadows are so rich in joy.
News from Verona! How now, Balthazar? Dost thou not bring me letters from the friar? How fares Juliet? Is my father well? How fares my lady? That I ask again, for nothing can be ill if she be well.
And she is well. Nothing can be ill. Her body sleeps in Capulet's monument. Her green mortal heart with angels live. I saw her laid low in her kindred's vault. Presently, took post to tell it you. Pardon me for bringing these ill news, sir, since you did leave it to my office.
Is it even so? Then I defy you, stars! Thou knowest my lodging. Get me ink and paper and hire post horses.
I will hence tonight.
I do beseech you, sir, have patience. Your looks are pale and wild, and do import some misadventure.
Tush, thou art deceived. Leave me and do the thing I bid thee do. Ask thou no letters from the friar.
No, my good lord.
No matter. Get thee gone, and hire those horses. I will be with thee straight.
Well, Juliet, I will lie with thee tonight. Let's see for meat. Oh, mischief. Thou art swift to enter in the thoughts of desperate men. I do remember an apothecary,
and hereabout she dwells, which late I noted, with tattered weeds. Meager were her looks. Sharp misery had worn her to the bones. As I remember, this should be the house. Oh, being holiday, the beggar's shop is shut. What ho! Apothecary!
Who calls so loud?
Come hither, you. I see that thou art poor. Poor. There is 40 ducats. Let me have a dram of poison. Such soon speeding gear as will disperse itself through all the veins, that the light weary taker may fall dead, and that the trunk be discharged of breath, as violently as hasty power fire doth hurry from the fatal cannon's wound.
Such mortal drugs I have, but Mantua's vows death to any he that utters them.
Art thou so pale and full of wretchedness, and fearest to die? Famine is in thy cheeks, need and oppression starveth in thine eyes. Contempt and beggary haze upon thy back. The world is not thy friend, nor the world's law. The world affords no law to make thee rich. And be not poor, but break it, and take this.
My poverty, but not my will, consents.
I pay thy poverty and not thy will.
This in any liquid thing you will, drink it off. And if you had the strength of 20 men, it would dispatch you straight.
There is thy gold. Worse current poison to men's souls, doing more murder in this loathsome world than these small compounds thou mayst not sell. I sell thee poison. Thou hast sold me none. Farewell. Buy food and get thyself in flesh. Come, cordial, and not poison. Come with me to Juliet's grave. There I must use thee.
Finding him, the searchers of the town, suspecting that we are both in the house, for the infectious pestilence that reigned, sealed up the doors, and would not let us forth, though so that my speed to Mantua there was stayed.
Oh, who bear my letter than Romeo?
I could not send it. Here it is again. Oh, get a messenger to bring it thee, so that they have infection.
Oh, unhappy fortune. By my brotherhood, the letter was not nice, but full of charge and of dear import. And the neglecting may do much danger. Fragon, go in. Get me an iron crow and bring it straight into my cell.
Brother, I'll go for it and bring it to you.
Now I must to the monument alone. Within this 3 hours will fair Juliet wake. She will beshrew me much that Romeo hath no notice of these accidents. But I will ride again to Mantua and keep her at my cell till Romeo come. Poor living corse. enclosed in a dead man's tomb.
Churchyard tread, being gloom sun firm with the digging up of graves, but thou shalt hear it. Whistle then to me as a signal that thou hearest something approach. Give me those flowers. Do as I bid thee, go.
I fear to stand alone in the churchyard, yet I will admit you.
Water nightly will I do, for wanting that with tears distilled by moans. The obsequies that I believe will keep, nightly shall be to strew thy grave with weep. The boy gives warning that something doth approach. What cursed foot wanders this way tonight, to cross my obsequies in true love's writ? With a torch. Muffle me night a while. Hold it. Take this letter. Early in the morning, see thou delivered to my lord and father. Give me the light. Upon thy life I charge thee. Whate'er thou hearest or seest, stand on aloof. Do not interrupt me in my course, or by heaven, I will tear thee joint by joint and strew this hungry churchyard with thy limbs. The time and my intents are savage wild, more fierce and more inexorable far than empty tigers of the roaring sea.
He'll be gone, sir, and not trouble you.
So shalt thou show me friendship. Take thou that. Live and be prosperous. Farewell, good fellow. For all the same, I will hide me hereabout. What his looks I fear, and I doubt. Detestable Ma, thou womb of death, gore with the dearest morsel of the earth. This is the clownish haunting Montague that murdered my lost cousin, which briefly disposed of the fair creature die. Here has come to do some villain ashamed to the dead dark bodies. I will apprehend him. Stop thy hollow toil, vile Montague! Can vengeance be pursued further than death? I do apprehend thee. Obey and go with me. For thou must die.
Must indeed, and therefore came I hither.
Tempt not a desperate man. Leave me. Fly hence. Look upon these gone. Let them affright thee. I beseech thee, hear me.
put another sin upon my head by urging me to fury. Oh, be gone, by heaven, I love thee better than myself, for I come hither armed against myself. Stay not, be gone. Leave, and hereafter say a madman's mercy bid thee run away.
I do defy thy conjuration, and apprehend thee for a villain here.
Wilt thou provoke me? Then have it thee, boy. Faith, I will. Let me peruse this face. Mercutius Kinsman, the noble County Paris. Said my manners might be tossed and sold, did not attend him as we rode. I think he said Paris should have married Juliet. Said he not so? Did I dream it so? Oh, my mad, hearing him talk of Juliet, to think it was so. Writ in sour misfortune's book. Oh, I'll bury thee in a triumphant grave. A grave? Oh no. A lantern slaughtered you. Have they been married? Which their keepers call a lightning before death. Oh, how may I call this a lightning? Power yet upon thy beauty. Beauty's ensign yet is crimson in thy lips and in thy cheeks. And death's pale plague is not man to bear. Tybalt, liest thou there in thy bloody sheet? Oh, what favor can I do to thee than with that hand that cut thy youth in twain? That was thine enemy. Oh, forgive me, cousin. Oh, dear Juliet, why art thou so fair? Shall I believe it? Unsubstantial death is amorous, and the lead abhorred monster keeps thee here. In dark to be his paramour? For fear of that, I still will stay with thee, and never from this palace of dim night depart again. Here will I remain with worms that are thy chambermaids.
here will I set upon my everlasting rest, and shake the yoke of inauspicious thoughts from this poor weary flesh. Eyes, look here, lass. And arms, take your last embrace. Doors of righteousness. In David's mark, to him who is in death. Come, unsavory guide. Come, uncommon valor. Here's to my lady.
Francis, be my speed. Oh, tonight have my old feet stumbled at graves.
Who's there?
Here's one, a friend, and one who knows you well.
Bliss be upon you. Tell me, who is my friend? What torches, dome that vainly lends its light to rubs and eyeless skulls, as I discern it burneth from the temple's monument?
It's our Sorbonne, sir. There my master, one that you love.
Who is it?
Romeo.
How long has he been there?
Till a half an hour.
Go with me to the vault!
I dare not, sir. My master knows not that I'm gone hence. Fearful did met me with death if I stay to look on his intent.
Stay then. I'll go alone. Fear comes upon me. Oh, much I fear some ill, unlucky thing.
So I did sleep here under his yew tree. I dreamt that my master another fought. My master has slew him.
Romeo! Romeo! What, Paris too? And steeped in blood? Oh, what an unkind hour was guilty of this lamentable chance. The lady's yours. Unnatural sleep. A greater power than we can quarter Dick has thwarted our intents. Come, come away! Oh, thy husband and thy bosom there lies dead, and Paris too. Come, come away! I'll dispose of thee among the sisterhood of holy nuns. Stay not to question, for the watch is coming. Come, go, good Juliet, for I dare no longer stay.
Go! Get thee hence, for I will not away.
sight. Who lies the county slain? And you lay bleeding, warm, and you kill. Who here hath lain these 2 days buried? Go tell the prince. Run to the Montagues. Raise up the captains. Others search.
Took his mannock and his spade from him. He's coming from the church outside.
A great suspicion. Keep the friar too.
What should it be that they so shriek abroad?
The people in the street call Romeo, some Juliet, some Paris, and all run with open outcry toward our monument.
My lord, here lies the county Paris slain, and Romeo dead, and Juliet dead before, both warm and you killed. And here is the friar, and slaughtered Romeo's man, both fit with tools upon and to open a dead man's tomb.
Oh, heaven! Wife, look how our daughter bleeds. This dagger hath mistaken Lois' house. Is empty on the back of Montague, and is missheathed in my daughter's bosom.
Oh, me, this sight of death is Isabel that warms my old age to a sepulchre. Come, Montague, for thou art early up.
Alas, alas, my wife is dead tonight. Grief of my son's exile stopped her breath. What further woes conspire against mine age?
Look, and thou shalt see.
What manners is in this? Press before thy father to a grave?
Where be these enemies? Capulet! Montague! See what a scourge is laid upon your hate. That heaven finds means to kill your joys. And I, for winking at your discords, too, have lost the price of kinsmen. All are punished.
Oh, Brother Montague, give me thy hand. This is my daughter's jointure. For no more can I demand.
But I can give thee more. Till I'll raise her statue in pure gold. Whiles Verona by thy name is known, there shall no figure at such rate be set, except of true and faithful Juliet.
As rich shall Romeo's by his lady lie, poor sacrifices of our enmity.
A gloomy peace this morning. The son of sorrow will not show his head. Go hence! To have no more talk of these sad things. Some shall be pardoned, and some punished. For never was there a story of more woe than that of Juliet.